Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate, and my shirt today is a classic on a couple of levels. So it is an exploded OG Macintosh 128K, and I checked, and I've actually had this shirt for like more than a decade, which suggests that I might need to update my wardrobe. But on the other hand, I was a recent college grad when I bought this shirt, and it still fits, so go me. Maybe. Anyway, enough of all that. Let's get into this week's latest developer news. So first up, just some reminders of some of our upcoming events. Microsoft Ignite will be in Orlando from November 4th through 8th, and this event is actually sold out, but you can still get on the wait list. And if you are there and you see me or any of your other Channel 9 favorites, please be sure to say hello, because we always love to see you. And if you can't make it to Microsoft Ignite, you may be able to make it to Microsoft Ignite the tour. And this year, we will be in 30 cities across the globe delivering awesome, deeply technical content for developers and IT pros. And like I said last week, and I've said in the past, I had a blast at the tour last year. And so if you can make it to one of the events, I highly recommend it. Links to both Microsoft Ignite and Microsoft Ignite the Tour are in the show notes and description down below. Next up, this was a massive, and I mean massive, week for .NET news, both with the .NET Conf and the release of .NET Core 3.0. And so I've got a ton of links to the biggest announcements and videos from .NET Conf in the show notes and the description, but I wanted to spend a little bit of time on some of the highlights. So first, .NET Core 3.0 is now available. Finally, this is great. It includes many improvements, including adding Windows Forms and WPF, adding new JSON APIs, there's support for ARM64, and improving performance across the board. C# 8 is also part of this release, and it includes nullable async streams and more patterns. F# 4.7 is also included, and it's focused on relaxing syntax so that you can target .NET Standard 2.0. And alongside .NET Core 3.0 is also ASP.NET Core 3.0 and EF Core 3.0. That's also available. And also alongside .NET Core 3.0, Visual Studio 2019 16.3 and Visual Studio for Mac 8.3 were released and are required if you want to use .NET Core 3.0 with Visual Studio. And so .NET Core 3.0 is actually part of Visual Studio 2019 16.3. You can just get the .NET Core by simply upgrading to the latest version of Visual Studio 2019. And also regarding the .NET Conf, not only can you view all the videos on Channel 9 and on our YouTube, but I've got a link for the .NET Conf presentations as well if you want to see the slides more easily. And so, like I said, I've got links to blog posts and .NET Conf keynotes and deep dive videos and more in the show notes in the description. But this is a massive release, and we've been talking about it since Microsoft Build 2018. And I just really wanted to give a huge congratulations to the team for all the hard work that went into this release. Speaking of Visual Studio, Xamarin.Android support has been updated for Android 10.0 in Visual Studio 16.3 and Visual Studio for Mac 8.3. And more details are in the show notes and the description. And in some other Xamarin news, there is a new Xamarin Plus Azure Functions challenge. And this is a really cool kind of a cross, I guess, promotion challenge between the two teams. And so the Xamarin and Azure Functions teams work together to create a challenge that lets you use your existing .NET skills to build and run a mobile app built with Xamarin that can connect to a serverless Azure function running on the cloud. And so you basically complete the challenge following steps provided, and you are then automatically entered for a chance to win one of our prizes. And it's that simple. And so there will be 1,000 randomly selected participants who get a $25 Xbox Gold gift card, and 10 participants will be randomly selected to get a pair of Surface headphones. And so I've got details on the challenge, how you can complete it, and how you can enter to win in the show notes and the description. The Windows Terminal was one of my favorite announcements from Microsoft Build, and the team just released a brand new preview build. And actually, with this release, the team has switched the syntax so that this version is 19.09 for September 2019. And new features in this release include the inclusion of the new Cascadia code font that we talked about last week. Plus, there's a brand new setting schema which helps you manage your profiles.json file. And there are a couple of other new features and bug fixes too, so be sure to update. And the Windows Terminal team also posted their roadmap on GitHub, and the goal is basically to have Windows Terminal feature complete by the end of the year, and then spring 2020 is targeted as when they want to release version 1.0. And so I've got a link to the blog post, the GitHub repo, in the show notes and description, and you can install or update to the new Windows Terminal in the Microsoft Store. In some amazing VS Code extension news, I wanted to give a shout out to Ben Coleman, who is a cloud architect for Azure in the UK, and he released a new extension called the ARM Template Viewer, and this is actually super cool. So what it does is it shows you a graphical preview of the Azure Resource Manager, or ARM, templates. And so it'll show you all the resources with the official Azure icons, and it'll also link between those different resources. So it's a really great way to visualize what's going on. You can drag and drop and move icons as you please. It's really neat, and it's actually been successfully tested to work with all 890 plus Azure Quick Start templates. It's amazing. Anyway, this is super awesome. I've got a link to download it in the show notes in the description. Now, usually I use this time to give a shout out to the various videos on Channel 9 this week, but this week was basically just .NET Conf all the time. So again, I've got links to that content earlier in the release notes. And now it's time for my pick of the week. So, in my not-so-humble opinion, one of the best television shows from the last few years, if not the last decade, is The Good Place. And if you haven't seen it, it's a sitcom about the afterlife, and it manages to be both funny and it actually asks some really interesting philosophical questions. And so in the United States, anyway, it returned for its final season this week. And as of this recording, I haven't seen the season premiere, but given its great history, I know it's going to be awesome. And so The Good Place is on Netflix in most countries, and so if you want to watch it, even if it isn't specifically about tech, I still think it's pretty great, so you should check it out. Let me know some of your favorite shows, tech or otherwise, in the comments, and let me know your thoughts about any of our other stories. If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like on YouTube. Hit that like button, it really helps us out, and go ahead and subscribe to Microsoft Developer as well, so you can get all of your nerd needs. See you next time.